The Lowry Hill neighborhood is now under a gypsy moth quarantine. Thousands of these moth caterpillars are damaging trees, and if precautions aren't taken, the threat could spread. Gordon Severson explains what this means for homeowners.
So these are caterpillars that were collected from the quarantined area.
An invasive pest has found a new home in Minneapolis, one that's claimed countless trees on the East Coast, but only surfaced in Minnesota about a decade ago.
It defoliates the trees, and it can eat over 300 species of trees,
making them more susceptible to disease and infection, and if left unchecked, the trees could die.
This tree behind me here on Summit Avenue is where this infestation started. The owner didn't want to go on camera with us, but did explain that about 3 weeks ago, he discovered a dark clump of caterpillars on that tree and decided to call it in.
Jennifer Bernstein lives a few houses down the street.
Everybody is a little bit concerned about that.
She currently has two gypsy moth traps in her front yard, but she hadn't actually seen the bugs until this afternoon when her neighbor Raphael brought one over.
At your house you found those?
Yep.
He lives a few houses further down the street, which shows how fast the bugs are actually spreading. Plant pest specialist Marissa Streifel says they can quickly take over a neighborhood.
In this case, we're restricting the movement of woody debris, branches and yard clippings, tree trimmings.
The quarantine zone affects a few dozen homes from West Franklin Avenue up to Mount Curve Avenue and from Irving to DuPont. Since this infestation was found so quickly, experts think they'll be able to control the bugs until they can spray the entire neighborhood with pesticides early next spring.
I feel good about that, at least, that people are paying attention to this and that, you know, potentially it could save the trees.
In Minneapolis, Gordon Severson, Care 11 News.
Anyone in this new quarantine area should avoid taking yard waste to the compost site, except for grass clippings. Now, an infestation in Richfield was eradicated earlier this spring, and ag officials think they can do it again in Lowry Hill.